just received this package today, and it should be a Centipede on the Dreamcast, so let's open it up and find out. If I can do with one hand. So there it is. It's obviously an NTSC game because this never came out as a PAL game, and it looks like it's in brand new condition actually, apart from there's like a little crack there. This is a 3D remake of Centipede, and it does have the arcade original on the disc. There's the disc. And that looks in good condition. Whoops. So yeah, let's take a look at Centipede for the Dreamcast. So this is the main part, the main game, which is classed as the adventure. And what you mainly have to do is to just basically shoot the centipedes, and that's all you need to do to progress through the level and to make it onto the next level. You can also do other things like rescue the wee people, as you can see there, and there's other bugs as well that are running about everywhere, and you don't have to shoot them, but you know they're just there to hinder you. The game is made up of six different worlds, and each world contains six levels, I think. Now you can get weapon power-ups, and you get them either by finding a weapon power-up, or by you can see I'm using one there, or by shooting a flashing mushroom. And the power-up will either be a primary weapon power-up, which will mean that it will run out after a certain amount of time, or it will be a secondary weapon power-up, and you're limited to the amount of shots that you have. Now the graphics aren't that great at all. They kind of look like PlayStation 1 graphics, only like they've been updated a bit for the Dreamcast. In fact, maybe it is a PlayStation 1 port, I'm not sure. But I don't mind, you know, I don't really care about graphics that much. I think the actual gameplay, I think it's a fun game, you know. It doesn't seem like the sort of game that many people would like. It's kind of like a bad movie, you know. It's like one of those bad movies which has, you know, it was made on a low budget, you know, it has bad special effects, but for some reason you just like it. And that's what this game is like to me. The music is good. I think it pretty much suits the game. But I picked this game up for £9 on eBay, and the postage and packing was £2, so that was £11 altogether. And I think it was definitely worth it. I've been playing this a lot. Thank you. Now you can actually strafe in this game, but for some reason I always forget to use it most of the time. You do have different views as well, and you just access the different views by pressing the by pressing down or up on the D-pad. And I think on these views where it's more first person, I think the game looks a lot better, but it is a lot more difficult. It's not, the views aren't really that practical for for actually playing the game. It does make the game a lot more harder, so it's best really to play the game on the default view, which is the furthest view. You also have the arcade original of Centipede. I'm not sure if it's exactly the same. I have heard that it's supposed to have been updated a little bit, but I'm not sure because I've never played the arcade original. It's not too bad. I mean, I've played Centipede on the older consoles, like the Atari, a bit on the Commodore 64, and I do enjoy those a lot. But this one, it seems too fast. The game seems too hard. Really, I can't really last that long on it. But yeah, that's Centipede for the Dreamcast. It's an NTSC game only. So you will need if you're in the UK, if you're in Europe or Australia, you will need you will need your Dreamcast to either be modded, or you'll need to use a boot disc like a. I use the DCX boot disc, and it's really simple to use. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.